EWF World Championship match. Gary Epps, Man in Black, defending against Brandon Gatson right here tonight. And this is one of the most anticipated matches in recent memory, Matt. Between the Man in Black and Gary, and Brandon Gatson.
You'd like to see the Man in Black versus Gary Epps, wouldn't you?
Interesting. Gary Epps goes around with that world championship belt like he's the world champ.
Well, in a lot of ways he is.
He's helped guide the Man in Black towards that championship.
Which makes him, in a lot of ways, the champion too. Because if it wasn't for Gary Epps, the Man in Black wouldn't be the EWF World Heavyweight Champion.
Well, I wouldn't go that far. He had a big, healthy
hand. He wouldn't even be here.
That I'll give it out. Man in Black has been unstoppable for under a year here in the EWF.
You've been on Twitter and Facebook and Instagram. You see all these pictures Gary Epps taking with the championship with other people.
Gary Epps is taking this championship belt all over the place. He doesn't leave the house without it.
He's proud of it.
And well, you know, rightfully so. This is the most prestigious championship here in this business. The EWF World Heavyweight Championship.
Have you ever been proud of something and you bragged everybody about?
Absolutely.
And I don't mean the hot dog eating contest you won, right?
Absolutely not. Brandon Gatson trying to go for the inverted DDT. And the Man in Black says, I don't think so. Goes to the outside. And that's got to play with the mind, the mental mind frame of Gatson. And Gatson. Landed on the apron, Man in Black back into the ring. Gatson through the ropes of the shoulder block. Over the top rope, now going for the sunset flip.
Oh!
Got a kick to the
and
side.
And that's the experience of Brandon Gatson right there.
Gatson goes for the cover. And only gets a two count.
He saw that the sunset flip wasn't going to work. The Man in Black rolled through. So he just put the brakes on and kicked him right in the side of the head. Oh, inverted atomic drop.
Gatson with a huge right hand, knocking the Man in Black down. Gatson now with the Man in Black back up to his feet. Irish whip into the corner. Gatson in the elbow. Gatson now with the Man in Black Irish whip in the ropes. Man in Black holds on, goes underneath that bottom rope to the outside. Man in Black makes his way over towards Gary Epps. Gary Epps is asking the referee for a timeout. Gatson quick to follow on the outside. Stalking his prey like it's Predator Week on the Discovery Channel. And Man in Black right here. Oh, a little too close for comfort. What a headbutt there by Gatson.
Keep him away from us.
Yeah, come on, somebody.
Maybe we should put ourselves in a cage.
Big old clear box around us.
Get like the old school blue cage, you know. Put that around us.
Oh, Gatson scaring Gary Epps off.
Oh!
And that's not gonna feel good.
No.
Wow.
Not at all.
The Man in Black rolls back into the ring. Gatson's still on the outside. And he's gonna be out there for a while.
Yeah, just take the count out. Take the count out.
Well, you would keep the title.
It ain't the champion's job to beat his opponent. It's his opponent's job to beat the champion.
Well, he's got nothing to prove. It's Gatson.
Exactly. A lot of times, that's how champions lose their title. It's because their pride gets to them, their egos. As the match goes on, they go, I gotta beat this guy. You don't have to beat anybody. They have to beat you. You're the champion, that's it.
Man in Black, oh, what a huge drop kick that was. Flying through the air to the back of Gatson, right into the ropes. Makes the cover of the Man in Black only for a two count. And you know what? To the advantage of the Man in Black, he's got a man like Gary Epps on the outside to always remind him about exactly what you just said. So he's got a man in his ear on the outside. He'll coach him along the way.
And that goes back to why I'm telling you that Gary Epps, in a lot of ways, is the EWF champion.
Definitely got a smart mind.
Because if it wasn't for him, the Man in Black wouldn't even be here.
Man in Black in the corner there with Gatson. Look at the agility of the man in black. It looks like he's air surfing. Gatson. Still in that corner.
And wait, let me tell you this from personal experience. You can work on a leg, you can work on an arm, you can work on the back, you can work on the neck. That's all. Oh, beautiful clothesline.
Nicely done. Man in black now quickly goes for the cover, hooks the leg of Gats, and only gets the two count. Gary's upset over that.
But literally the most effective tool you can use, the most effective offense, is to cut off the oxygen flow. Because if you can't breathe, the longer the match goes, the more tired, the more exhausted, the more lethargic you're gonna get.
Wait a minute!
Oh!
Out of nowhere, Gatson with that spin kick. Hooks the leg, are we gonna get a new champ? Oh, only two count. What a kick, right to the chest, maybe got the jaw. From the man in black onto Brandon Gatson. Main event here tonight, Wrestling Night in the Empire.
Good low blows when the ref's not looking real good.
They're effective. May not be right, but they are effective.
Yeah, he's not right.
Brandon Black with Brandon Gatson into the ropes. Ooh. European uppercut.
The chair set him on fire and beat him in the head.
Oh, yeah, that's very humane.
Know about being humane.
I better know a lot more about it than you would.
Oh, really?
Mr. Sinister?
Really? What'd you eat today? Want to go there with you? Focus on the match.
And behind the ref's back, Gary Yap choking Gatson. Ref needs to turn around. Come on. Gary is choking.
Again, cutting off the oxygen. And also to my point about how Gary Yap, in a lot of ways, is the EWF champion.
Certainly acts like it.
There's a right to.
I don't think I've seen the man in black wear that the championship belt around his waist. It's all been Gary. Gary, yeah, crazy the performance here tonight of his world champion, the man in black. Black makes his way over to Gatson. He's caught up in the ropes here. The right hand there by the man in black. Man in black to Gatson. Iron whip into the ropes. Gatson. Waistlock go behind. Trying to go for some kind of a pinning combination. Only got a two count. Man in black. Right back to the attack of Brandon Gatson. Man in black now taunting the crowd here in the EWF arena. I don't know if I can agree with that. That's wasting time. You don't want to waste time against an opponent like Brandon Gatson.
For once, we're in agreement, Wade. I don't think you should waste any time.
Gatson trying to get back up to his feet.
If he wants to do anything, distract the ref again, allow Gary Yap to choke out Gatson some more.
That's one strategy.
I mean, Justin Borden's easily distracted.
Look at Gatson.
He obviously doesn't watch any matches because he falls for the same thing every time.
Ooh, Gatson connects with a kick there. That's where the man in black's got him up here. That scoop. And the slam. Gatson going to be able to capitalize.
He held on, he grabbed his hold of his lower back. I mean, sometimes we don't see things, but there may be some kind of injury going on that happened during the match just from taking the wrong step. Just from the way you went into the turnbuckle, the way you hit the ropes. That can cause an injury, and we won't even be aware of it.
Long twist and turn can do it.
Yeah. Oh!
Well, Brandon Gatz got that kick in. Gatz down on all fours. Well, what the story was, man in black is down now.
That's not something I don't want to think about.
Both men are down. Man in black, the world champion.
You have to put it like that. What? Down on all fours.
Because he was. What else do you want me to describe it?
Say he's down. Don't say he's on all fours.
He's in the corner. Randy Gadsden using the bottom rope as support on the outside there. Here we at with the Man in Black. The Man in Black is trying to get back in the ring. Man in Black still on the outside.
Now he's back in the ring.
Back in now. Gary out. His Man in Black. Wait a minute, caught with Gary. With Gadsden. In the ropes.
Oh!
Now that was a collision of epic proportion between Gadsden and the Man in Black.
Let them count them both down. That means the Man in Black retains the championship.
You're right.
More importantly, Gary Yap retains the championship.
Who is the champion? Is it Gary Yap or is it the Man in Black?
Officially, it's the Man in Black.
Yes.
But in a lot of ways, it's also Gary.
So it was a gray area. Yeah. Unnecessary blanket. Wait, wait a minute. Look at Brandon Gadsden. Gadsden, oh my! Over the top rope! Gadsden put his body on the line for the EWF World Championship.
That space flying tiger drop made famous in Japan. I saw it.
Yes, I did. Gary Yap over here asked me.
Couldn't have done it better myself, Gary.
I would love to see you try that.
More impressive than you trying.
Whoa, Gadsden trying to go for that cutter back into the ring. Man in Black. Oh! Oh! Man in Black just got Gadsden. We're going to get
a new champion.
Gadsden goes for the cover, too.
No, he kicked out.
What?
He kicked out.
How did the Man in Black kick out of that? He just got Gadsden. There is no way that he could have done that. How did he do that, Matt?
Well, I don't know how he did it, but he did it.
Gadsden has Man in Black in the corner. Gadsden backing up to the opposing corner. Gadsden now trying to get a breath. Oh, wait a minute, Gadsden now. Oh, wait a minute, Man in Black scouted it. Has an answer for Brandon Gadsden. Man in Black's got Gadsden up here. Oh! Like a snap jackhammer. How close was that?
Drove him down on his head, waiting like a brain buster. There we go, crossface.
Crossface applied. Gadsden almost in the center of the ring.
Yeah, but he wasn't able to get the legs around the arm.
Well, before it was locked in all the way, Gadsden smartly was able to nudge his way over to the side a little, get a little closer to the ropes. Wait a minute now, Van de Black is not careful. Look at that clothesline, Man in Black now with Gadsden.
Oh!
And a backstabber there. Goes for the cover, does not hook the leg, only gets it.
Yeah, that was a bit of an arrogant cover.
This match continues at a main event, Wrestling Night in the Empire. And what a night of action it has been. Got Brandon Gadsden back up to his feet.
Got Rich.
What we're going to see here. Brandon Gadsden.
Corey Guerrero special.
And that does not look like it feels good. The pain that Gadsden's got to be. Oh, wait a minute. Gadsden now. Into the ropes. Gadsden charging in. Oh, spine buster by the Man in Black.
Nobody rolls him up.
Are we going to get a new world champ now?
Oh!
Snap DDT quickly for the cover. Only got a two. Unbelievable.
What's the ref when you start counting?
Yeah, both men are down. Ref now started the count.
Yeah, he had to wait 10 seconds before he counted the 10, try and count the 10.
Maybe he had to catch his breath. Well, the breath-taking match is eventual for the EWF World Championship. Man in Black's back up to his feet.
You're saying the referee can get, is getting winded, right?
actually saying that this is one incredible matchup.
I think the ref is out of shape.
I don't know when to call him this. This is great.
Well, we know you're out of shape.
Brandon Black on the middle rope.
No, he caught him.
Trying to go for that front drop kick.
Figure four.
Gadsden's got the figure four locked
in. And he's got it in the center of the ring.
Brandon Black's got nowhere to go. Referee in position as well to see.
Gary, you're going to lose the championship.
Brandon Black is trying to turn, trying to roll over that figure four. Gary's trying to help the man in black. And the referee's counting now. And Gary's in the ring. The heck is wrong with Gary?
It doesn't matter. He's got to break the hold.
Man in black is able to get to that bottom rope thanks to Gary Yap.
Gary doesn't want to lose the championship.
Referee having stern words with Gary Yap. Oh, Brandon Gadsden.
Hey, wait a minute.
Brandon Gadsden's got a hold of Gary Yap on the apron here. And Gary's going to get what he deserves.
Gary's but Gadsden turned his back on the man in black.
Brandon Gadsden, oh, wait a minute. Oh, moved out of the way. Brandon Black almost colliding into Gary Yap. Right in the air, behind the rest back. Inverted DDT, Scorpion Death Drop.
Yeah, but Gary's got the ref distracted.
The ref needs to turn around. We should have a new world champion right now.
You don't know that, Wade.
Come on, ref, turn around, focus. Oh, Gadsden now with Gary. Oh, Gary brought into the ring the hard way here. Gadsden with Gary. Oh, there you go. Right hand to Gary Yap. And Gary goes down. Oh.
What did I say earlier, Wade?
Yeah, you said go for it. Behind the ref's back, a low blow. Man in black got it.
Got the Cobra Clutch into a Russian leg sweep.
Still holding on.
Reversed it into a crossface.
And the referee, seeing how much Gadsden has, it's more like a Cobra Clutch crossface. That has got to be painful.
That was pretty impressive on Gary Adams' part. He kept his sunglasses on the whole time.
Yeah, he did. Gadsden's trying to get to the rope. The man in black stopping Gadsden, relinquishes the hold and puts a beat down on the challenger, repositions Gadsden to face away from the rope. That's genius.
Got him back in that Cobra Clutch face.
Referee asking Gadsden, do you want to continue? That's it. That's it.
Gadsden's out. Gadsden's out. They're saying as a result of a submission, but I didn't see Gadsden submit.
I didn't see him submit either.
I think he passed out.
He might have passed out. That could be very well the case there. Oh, hey, wait a minute. Mega King's out here now. What's Mega King doing out here?
Tommy, what are you doing? Why do you care about Gadsden? The first time, Wade, I'm confused.
I'm confused as well.